36 or 37 laps out of a tank of fuel. It's amazing.
Okay, here's the critical shot. Murphy coming into the pits. 45 or 35 seconds up the road from Paul Radisich. If our sums are correct, that means by the time this car rejoins the circuit, it'll probably come out just behind Radisich. We're going to watch this with bated breath as they come in. Greg Rust is on the spot.
This is an absolutely crucial stop. Murph has dived out of the car like lightning. Stephen Richards very quickly in. Now we've lost a front wheel nut here. The boys will be very quickly onto that. 10 seconds down. Stevie's strapped in, ready to go already. And Freddie's told me straight out they're only going to put the absolute minimum amount of fuel needed to get them across the line. 19 seconds gone, 20 seconds gone. Stevie's on the deck, 22 seconds.
So just under 22 seconds, a slick stop under enormous pressure. And what we're going to do now is keep an eye on the track, because we've got to watch out for that Shell Ford. That's the McDonald's Commodore. Now, where is it?
They're going to get out.
There it is. There's Paul Radisich, second place.
The winch car's going to get out in front if he gives it to it now.
Oh, boy. Have we got a battle on our hands, and the fans know it too. Look at Stephen Richards.
Paul's on warm tyres that are nicely up the pressure. Steve Richards is on tyres that have probably got 18 pounds in them, so it won't be very pleasant for a couple of laps, but he's a great driver, Steve Richards, and a terrific
You couldn't ask to have a better man at the wheel, could you, John Bell? This is incredible pressure. Wins Commodore versus Shell Ford. Stephen Richards, Paul Radisich, they've been going at it all day. It looked like earlier when Richards and Murphy were leading, they still had to come in for their brake change. They might relinquish that lead, but they caught hard. Look at Radisich, bounce back. John Bell, what happened there?
There's a bit of a dip in the road there. He must have just hit it at the wrong angle. He tried to get around Stevie Richards, but look at that horse.
Paul Radisich using the horsepower of the Shell Ford. We've seen it all day. Side by side, 290 k's. Has Radisich got him? Yes, he sweeps across in front and takes the lead of the FAI 1000.
Down into challenge chase. The Rat leads. Now he's coming up on Paul Romano. The Siemens Mobile car gets a little out of shape. Now he clears it, and he's got some clear air ahead. The Shell team have their nose back in front. The Ford fans will be screaming. This will be interesting, guys. Look at this. Radisich.
Oh, what in the fence behind there?
Was that McLean?
That might be the safety car period. Let's see what happened back there. Looked like just coming through Reed Park. Yes, it was.
Llewellyn and McLean, they are out.
Just saw out of the corner of my eye that car clouting the wall big time. Well, is this the safety car, or is that car considered safe on the inside of the circuit? We'll be watching the starting officials very closely.
It really is probably in a safe spot, actually, where he's pulled up there.
Yeah.
That's John Llewellyn watching on Cam McLean behind the wheel in the Greenfield Mowers Falcon. Well, his 99 Bathurst campaign is over.
In Cameron's defence, he has been suffering a leaking differential for the last few laps. I wonder if that dumped a whole lot of oil on his back tyres, John.
I don't know, Mark. It looked like it went straight ahead. We get a replay, we'll be able to have a look at it. It might have broken something in the front end.
He's blown a tyre. Radisich has blown a tyre.
Oh, no.
No, this is race leader Paul Radisich. Front right has blown.
Well, you can hear the whole fans are going crazy along pit straight. They can see it on the big giant screens here.
The big problem with this as well, of course, is that flapping rubber is liable to do a lot of damage. I had a flat tyre at the Grand Prix 1 year and drove it back to the pits, and it took out the shock absorber. So
20 laps from home. When the luck is with you, the luck is with you. He's having trouble even turning the corner. The Holden fans are going ballistic.
Well, this is your seventh Bathurst start.
Yep.
And four retirements. The 23rd, the first, could be your second first.
We're not going to start talking about this.
That was the mockers on there.
Here's Dick Johnson, the number 17 Shell Helix Ford. His farewell drive. And currently runs in fifth position.
Oh,
it's all over for the 18 Ford. Paul Radisich, his day, his FAI 1000, after being so strong and leading for so long, it is all over.
You cannot believe how you can go from the highest of highs to the lowest of lows in such a short time frame.